everyone. Thank you so much for tuning back into my next Facebook Live. Today I'm going to show you a process of ironing to fuse on a photograph on a large scale panel. And then I've got a couple announcements at the end. So to get started, I have these panels built, but you can also buy them at Blick or Binders. There's a lot of different places that you can buy birch hardwood panels, which are perfect for encaustic. Then what I do is take the photograph, this is a small scale photograph, and glue it onto the panel with a product called Yes Paste. I've used that in a couple of my past videos, but that's what I did on this one. And you just wanna make sure the paste is really nice and smooth so you don't get any bubbles underneath your photograph. I have gone ahead and put wax on half of this, and I'm going to show you the rest of how I apply the wax. So this is clear beeswax, natural, has nothing mixed in it, no hardeners. And I start all the way off of one side and then take it to the other. So I don't have to be too careful. So I'm overlapping about a half an inch. Really getting that wax on nice and thick. So I've already done this on the other side of the photograph, and I have used two layers of clear wax. Right now I'm just going to use one so we can get started with the fusing. You can even touch up little areas like that if you feel like you haven't applied wax to the entire photo. You don't have to be too specific because this is all going to become molten again. All right, so now I use a household iron. And you know, if you can see this, but I set it to number one. If you do that any higher, then the wax is going to melt off of your photograph completely. You don't want that. So turn it to between one and two. And then I'm gonna start all the way off of one side and just apply a little bit of pressure and start moving it across. So this is melting the first layer and kind of getting it nice and warm. I'm going to actually turn that up to about 1.5. So you can kind of start to see I'm leaving the iron in one place for a little while. You see how that's now becoming nice and molten? So this is an option to use instead of a blowtorch. The reason that I like to do this is because there's no chance of burning the photograph beneath it. And also, after you have ironed the entire piece, you can kind of start moving the iron around and creating some really interesting marks. And see also how that iron is pushing some of the wax, like that. You could leave those little marks and ridges, and it creates a really wonderful texture that you absolutely cannot get with a blowtorch. Blowtorch will smooth out the piece completely, but the iron is actually making almost little veiny type of marks on them. So now you can see the image coming through beautifully. So I would just melt the wax on the entire rest of the photograph. I'll do that after we're done with this video. But once you have this wax molten, you don't have to go back and iron it again. It's going to turn kind of a white color, and that is just the wax melting. It is now saturated into this print, which is printed on a matte paper on an inkjet printer. That's very important because if you use a laser printer or photo paper, the wax will not melt into the paper. It won't fuse into the paper with this heat. It'll just sit right on top, and then it'll eventually peel off. So now, after that one is all molten, you can kind of start going more quickly. Just getting it around. These little marks. It's kind of fun to just dance with it a little bit. So there you go. That is how you use an iron to fuse wax onto. I'll hold it up, it will fall down. But this is what it's starting to look like. So now the wax is starting to get cool, so that'll be kind of milky looking. But never fear, that is going to clear up and be absolutely clear and beautiful, almost like resin, but more marks in between it. So if you have any questions, please post and ask me about that. Also, if you post today, you will get 20% off of your next workshop or private lesson. So post a question, let me know what you want to see in the future. I've been working on some wonderful alcohol inks for my art rep and for Interiors Market. This is such a fun way to create. It has nothing to do with wax. I actually do create alcohol inks on wax, but this one is on paper. And at Interiors Market, I'm about to deliver today a couple new paintings and also be creating these large for them. But these are two small pieces in a diptych that have some shellac and wax. That's a fun thing to learn. Maybe we can figure that out, even though we need to do that outside. The next thing I'd love to announce is that my website is being redesigned right now, and it is going to be so much easier to register and pay for workshops, and eventually we're going to have some of my artwork for sale on an online store. So that's going to be launched soon. I will let you know in a big post and announcement when that is going to be available. And the last thing is that I'm going to be selling a piece of artwork on Facebook the last day of every month. That will be May 31st this month. Last time we did that as a video and really couldn't see the piece very well, and Facebook didn't allow me to post a close-up photo of it along with the video. So this time on May 31st, I will be posting a piece, and you'll see the piece of artwork close up, you'll see it in an environment, you'll learn why I created it and the story behind it and materials I used, and you'll have everything you need to buy that online, and it will be up to 50% off. So this is a great opportunity to check into my Penetrice Facebook artist page at the end of the month and get a piece at a large discount. So thank you so much again for being here, and I'll see you next time.